okay, I'm going to do the experiment of differential pulse code modulation. In order to do the experiment of differential pulse code modulation, I'm going to select that DPCM by using this switch, okay. I've selected DPCM experiment. Then, coming to the functional block diagram of DPCM, first there is a sine generator, then DPCM modulator, then DPCM demodulator and a filter. First you need to connect a sine wave generator, okay, to a DPCM, modulator, okay. Next, the output of the modulator is given to the input to the demodulator, okay. Then the input, the output of the demodulator is given to the input to the filter. Then you are going to observe the output of in the filter, okay. First connect the CRO of the channel 1, okay, to the sine wave generator and observe the sine wave in the CRO, okay. You are getting a sine wave. Then just observe here. First, suppose here you are getting a sine wave. Connect the channel 2, you are getting the sine wave. Then observe the input to the quantizer. The input to the quantizer is again a sine wave. The input to the quantizer is again is a sine wave. Then observe the output of the quantizer. Okay. Connect another probe, another patch cut here, and observe the output of the quantizer. Okay. You will get the quantized output. Okay. You can vary the amplitude of the sine signal, of the input signal. Okay. Next, observe the modulator output. You will get a square wave. Vary the time division, okay. Then
okay. this is pulse coded output.
Yes, this is a modulated output.
Differential pulse coded modulated output.
It consists of a code words. That means you are going to represent in the form of code word. That means you are going to represent in the form of 00001.
That means that you are telling this analog signal has now been converted into digital data.
Digital signal, yes.
00001001. Okay, fine.
Then the input is given to the demodulator. Then you are going to observe the output at the modulator. Okay.
So basically what you did, you now took the modulated, that is the DPCM signal,
okay,
and you are feeding that to the demodulated block,
yes,
and you are checking what is the demodulated signal. So demodulated signal is again
the quantized version.
It is actually quantization error.
After quantization error signal, that means here I have encoded it and here I have decoded it.
Decoded it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Next I am going to observe the output at the filter. Okay.
So basically you are passing that particular signal to the filter.
Filter, and now I am observing the output of the filter. Okay. I am getting the exact output.
Sir,
can we say
why there is a phase delay between my input signal and output signal?
Because after processing the input signal, where we are modulated and we are demodulated, then there will be get some delay in the output signal.
So basically it means to say whenever there is a process that is happening on a signal, there will be certain amount of delay
between the input and output.
Yes.
Hence, we are getting a delay in this signal.
Yes, exactly,
but
sir.
Both the information are same.
Same information.
Because we have same frequency information.
Same
only thing is, it is delayed by some time.
Yes.
Okay, great. Thank you, sir. Thanks for explaining.